knowledge. It's because of the knowledge. That's it. When your knowledge is sound, you have created a foundation for your life. You have paved the way. That's what it's about. That is one of the gifts that the Honorable Grandmaster Chief had given me, is knowledge. No matter what, keep the knowledge. Ain't no man, ain't no woman, ain't no money gonna save you. It's the knowledge that you keep, the knowledge that you live by. So that's why y'all see me still in this office, still doing what I'm doing. Not going back to Babylon. I could have went back to Babylon. I could have went back to my family. I could have went back to that part of myself, but I knew. I just knew. I was like, no, if I go that direction, I'm just headed. I'm just going backwards. And I already know. I know my weaknesses. And I said, I ain't going to do that. You know, I knew what I had to do. I knew what it was about. So, yeah. All right, it's almost done. I got three more. No, four more. This is what spirituality is about. Now, we know spirit means energy, and spirituality is the study of energy. But true spirituality is when you get in touch with your true nature, because energy and nature is the same. So this is what spirituality is about. It's not about meditating. No. Because when you wake up, you're still right there. See, this is what true spirituality is about. The transformation, the action, the dying. Letting the one part of yourself die so the other part can really live and manifest and come up. That's what spirituality is all about. Facing yourself. Because at the end of the day, that's all it is you. Everybody's a reflection of you. So don't get caught up in religion. Don't get caught up in all these crazy-ass ways of being. It's you dealing with you, trying to find you to get away from your lower part of yourself to come into your higher self. That's all life's about. You connecting with yourself. And so many of us run away. So many of us run away from that. I know I do. Oh, okay. I did it. I wonder if I should cut. See, I ain't no barber. Look at this. See? So it's all gone, y'all. Hey, little buddy. Hey, little buddy. You see, mommy? Yeah, I know. I look crazy. Zen just stood up and started smiling. There it goes. Hair graffiti. Oh, okay, let me see if I can make it even. So I don't want to fuck it up. Flowery, it's not like. Okay, yeah, okay, you got this, girl, you got this. Okay, well. Now I'm about to go to the fabric store and get some fabric, some pretty fabric, and then just, you know. Be cute. But this is, y'all know, shit. I was walking around looking like this until she gave me an edge up. So he was just like, I'm tired, you look like a turtle. Yeah. And so when I wet it, because my hair is curly, so when I wet it, it's just gonna curl up and stuff, so. But yeah, obviously, it still can improve. But now, sis, it is what it is. Look at that. Look at that. Yeah. Your mama Sheba laughing, cause you know. He used to get. He be like, "Why y'all looking like that? Like, let me do something with y'all's hair." Oh, y'all gonna look younger. Yeah. And so now I got a little mullet. Got that little mullet right there, yeah. Got the little hanger. I know.
Shit.
I want y'all to be a part of this with me. I'm glad I did this. Because I know a lot of y'all was contemplating cutting your hair. So. The Danny Glover line. Yeah, I got that 80s, that bebop. I'm so great dancing. Because you know, I used to have that hair. You know what I'm talking about. The 80 babies know what I'm talking about. That's how they used to wear it. Color man, you got the color man all the time. I look like Ralph Transman. That's who I look like. Yeah, that's who I look like. Yeah. Yeah. I know. Yeah, so I could probably cut some more of that up. Earrings and my scars and do that. Hold on. Also, my child looks like Ronnie DeVoe. Can't take this walk seriously, and even though it's serious, but when you do the right thing, rejoice, be glad in it. It's just hair, you know what I mean? It'll grow back, because we all know the human being is the only species that when they cut their hair, it grows back, okay? But you just have to enjoy life for what it is. You came here to experience. You are a God came to experience what it means to be human. And this is one of the things, but to get back into knowing who you truly are. To be happy. If you're going through anything, any obstacle, any adversity, remember my face. Like, okay? remember this. And be like, you know what? It ain't that bad. Like, yeah, it ain't that bad. I'm thankful, Chief. Like, people been telling me that lately, like, man, you brave, but it's just like, when you in your purpose, when you in your calling, it's like breathing. This is like, okay, like, but I get it. I'm doing this for my reflection. You know, I'm putting myself out here for the world to see. But I'm not here for the world, I'm only here for the chosen. You know, I'm here for my soul family. That's what I'm doing this for. Yeah, y'all, so. don't say that. Don't say that. Collard greens. Don't say that. You know, I'm giving you a warning. You know, letting you know. Don't compare others to others. Okay? Yeah. Yeah, this is another side of faith. Because I'm faith. Like, you know, I'm serious and I'm mothering and, you know, but. It's about enjoying life and your purpose. It's about being happy. When you find what makes you happy, be happy. Like, enjoy it. And so this is me. Y'all are seeing me. I expose myself. You know, this is me. Can you do the same? Can you expose who you really are? Can you do that in front of the world? And it doesn't matter if they stone you. Or belittle you, or disown you, can you stand? really stand and look and look him in the eye. Can you do that? And don't waver. Stand firm in who you are. Regardless of what it looks like. If you can do that, you can stand next to me. You can be in carbonation, but if you can't, you just and then go about your business. Stay over there. This is what it takes, y'all. This is what it takes. Alright. So before I go, let me see how I can block. If y'all have any questions, let me see. Facts. Oh, K-Sweet wants to know my purpose. My purpose is to convict the weak and to collect the elite. On the divine knowledge of self, that our honorable Grandmaster Chief Enigia is here to bring the world, the Messiah. That is my calling. If you want to know, that's my purpose. That's my mission.
Time. Yep, your baby time. Do you hear?
I'm thankful. Yes, what are you doing? He's stuck. He's stuck under the chair. Yay! He's walking down, so he gets stuck and he can't. He's falling and he can't get up. That's pretty much. Body by Bezel. That's a warning. Yeah. Aww. You see? A lot of y'all already are saying things are already answered. Somebody said, so are you leaving or are you going to support the movement where you are? Leaving and supporting the movement is the same thing. Before you leave and go anywhere, you have to change your mindset. Because remember, you're under a program. Going to the tropics with the same program is not going to save you. You must change the program where you are. And the more that you immerse yourself in the knowledge, watch the videos of carbonation, and actually live what they're teaching, then that's when you will see that your reality will change because your mind has changed. Because everything is all in the mind. So this is the work. See, this is the reason why you see so many people leave and then come back. Or leave, go to carbonation, and come back and talk shit. Because they didn't truly know the knowledge. They were just being their astrological program, probably being hasty, and just going and trying to run away from themselves. But they were faced with themselves when they got there. And those people don't want to deal with themselves. So this is the work. This is what you have to do. You know. You gotta immerse yourself in the knowledge. You gotta move on knowledge. On the truth. That's what you have to do. And I was one of those people. I was one of those people. That's why you saw me leave, come back. Leave, come back. Because I was being faced with myself and I didn't truly absorb in the knowledge like I should have. Like I got it and I understood it. But that Mercury Sagittarius is always like forgetting the details, but it's the work. You still got to work on yourself. You got to stay in the knowledge. So if you don't even have a foundation of the truth, no matter where you go, you're going to face with yourself and you're going to come right back to what you was running away from. And so now I'm not running away. I'm doing the work. I'm learning it. I'm teaching it. I'm being it. So no matter where I am, I'm solid. That's what it's about. No matter where. That's what she told me. He was like, your security is in the knowledge. And in wanting and receiving the kingdom of heaven. It's not in no man, it ain't in nothing. It's in the knowledge that you keep and the truth that you stand on. So this is the work. This is what you have to do. And before you know it, your reality is going to manifest in what you truly believe in. Okay? So if you truly believe carbonation is your soul family, because if you on this frequency, if you watching these videos, they are, but you just let your demons get the best of you. This is what you have to do. You are responsible for your life. No one else. You're responsible for what you do, what you don't do. No one else. Okay, Bernie. Thanks for showing yourself. Oops. Yeah, I want y'all to say something. Say something. I want y'all to say something. I want y'all to say something. Let's go ahead and say it. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I'm still doing readings. I'm always doing astrology. I love to help people. I really do. So any of y'all want to learn how to read your chart and understand it, you know, you can hit me up at any time. You know, I'm here. That's part of the work. Yeah. Okay. Yes, he is. Okay, y'all. Well, I'm about to start my day again. You're gonna have a better day today. Yeah, he scared me yesterday. Oh my god. But hey, we got this. You and I got this. Okay. So we're gonna have a good day today. I'm going to go on YouTube and I'm still gonna do the chocolates. I'm still gonna do that. I still want to give y'all a message. And so stay tuned to that. You know, if you're not following me on Zen Life TV, please do that on YouTube. And yeah, so if y'all have any questions, comments, hit me up in my inbox. I love myself. You know, thank you guys for being here, for supporting me. Even the ones that are discouraging, you make me stronger. You make me stronger. Okay? I love myself.
I noticed you, you know, you getting that knowledge out that book. You better be careful, Chief, you know what I'm saying? All right? Elevating into the supernatural. That's a powerful book, Chief, you know? A lot of people ain't liking you reading this book, Chief. A lot of people don't like you reading this book, Chief. They don't like you reading these books. They're like, what is he doing?
Bit crazy.
Okay. You know what happens when you pick up this book? I don't give a fuck what you believe. What happens is the knowledge in the book, if you are a person, all right, that is allowed to see, because everybody ain't allowed to see. Everybody's not allowed to look in the book. See, I always put challenges out. Simple stuff. See, you know, Chief, if I want to know if you're under demonic possession or something, I'll ask you to read a verse out of the Bible. If you refuse, and you give me some song and dance about how the Bible makes you emotional, or the Bible makes you angry, or this, that, the other, then 9 times out of 10, you're under demonic possession. Either that, or God don't want you to read his book for some strange reason. All right? You know, it's either one or the two. See, anybody under demonic possession is not allowed to even open the book and read anything from it. If you were to read the Bible under demonic possession, you would have headaches. You would get irritated. You see what I'm saying? You might even I've challenged atheists and certain people. I said, well, you know, if this book ain't real, and everything in it is just smoke and mirrors, and you should be able to read it. You know, it's not a real book, so you should be able to read it and not be affected. All right? I've had people, like I might say, well, look, the book of Genesis ain't that long. If you look at the book of Genesis, it's not really, it's not even a whole book. Hell, the first, it's like four pages of Genesis is a family tree. That's a blamed Eve. This is why all of the women of the world are cursed. This is where the women get to not liking what the fuck I'm saying. Adam blamed Eve. He said, hey, don't get mad at me, dog. You gave me this bitch. I thought she was cool. Serpent could be any form of animal outside. Like serpents aren't just snakes. See, people got to look at that. And think about this, Chief. And look, Chief, I'm about to blow your motherfucking mind back. You ready for this? Let's talk about the fallen angels, the invisible forces on the earth. Now, you said, now, what Nature Boy calls it is being in your lower self. What happens in your lower self, Chief? Some things are thoughts, but others could be whispers. You see? Some things could be thoughts, but others could be a whisper. I know you've heard this a thousand times. The devil will come and whisper in your ear. The Quran talks about that. That the devil will whisper into the hearts of men. Everything starts with a thought. Now, your actions and thoughts are two separate things. What you think about and what you do is two separate things. I can come up here and lie to y'all, right? I can say, well...
Oh, shoot.
I'm going to stop. Look.
Homeboy said, damn, Vic, you really trying hard to be the new chief this. Wow. That's messed up.
I just stopped smoking. I don't smoke no more. I don't do none of this shit no more. I don't smoke. But then when you look at me, you see a cigarette in my hand and a blunt in my hand and all this other type of shit. You go, hold on, cuz. You said you wasn't smoking. But when we look at you, you blowing your motherfucking chest out. What the fuck are you doing? Okay. Anybody in the chat, just go for anybody. Anytime, let's say you are feeling depressed or feeling bad about something, you'll hear a faint voice inside your head that'll be your voice, but this voice is just telling you a bunch of negative shit. Like this voice will say, well, you'll never be shit. You'll never get anything done. You'll never reach your goals. And as this voice is saying this shit inside your head, you start repeating it out loud. I'll never get shit done. I'll never do any of this. I don't know what's wrong. Same thing with anger. Same thing with anger. If you are angry, you're liable to do something that you'll regret. We can get into a fist fight with somebody, right? We could be fist fighting somebody. And then a voice comes in your head and says, you know what? Go stab that nigga. And next thing you know, you walk into the kitchen. And you grab a knife. Fuck that. And as you're walking with this knife towards the individual, that voice is talking to you in your head like, yeah, he gonna die tonight. Yeah, make this motherfucker bleed. And this voice is just talking and nobody's paying attention to the voice. Nobody ever challenges the voice in your head. Alright? Nobody ever makes that challenge. Think about this. If you had a voice, if you're sitting there all alone, all right.
It's for the two squares.
But think about this voice. Nobody, this voice has all this control.
You're looking, bro.
All right.
No, that,
oh.
That was fun.
Okay. Yep. DC. This voice in your head. Some people call it a subconscious. Some people call it a conscious. Nature boy calls it lower self. I call it demonic. Okay, look, you know what I'm saying? Everybody has a name for it. Everybody has a name for it. But as you sit there in your thoughts, you are vulnerable. Okay? All of this example is given in the story of Job. You look at the story of Job. As it talks about God and the angels and this, that, the other. The devil went to God and said, man, look. The only reason why Job worships the ground you walk on is because you protect him. You know, that's like somebody saying to the chief, well, the only reason why Pisces respects you is because you protect him. But for once, touch everything he has, I bet you he cursed you to your face. Alright? Everything he has is already in your hands. Now, when God said that to Satan, what he was referring to was the fact that Satan is the ruler of the world.
He said, what in the entire church is going on here?
So that's why he said to her, everything that Job has is already in your hands.
Oh, boy.
Environment is always constantly trying to suggest something to you, whether you notice it or not. Constantly, we don't notice it. We think we're smart. And ain't no seed. You eat an apple and ain't no seed in it. The fruit don't even got no flavor no more. Hold on, let me. The fruit don't got flavor no more. Come on, bro. This shit's GMO, bro. And these niggas is GMO. And they like, oh yeah, we're making progress. No, nigga, you adapting into destruction, nigga. You are integrating into a burning house. Point blank, period. So, with that being said, I'm gonna give a couple people more calls, and I just wanted to do this little live. Cause, you know what I'm saying? People obviously think they could. I didn't know that was a school of thought. I'm so against Babylon, I didn't know that there was people out there that actually think that they can save Babylon, that we can make it a better place. I never knew that mind was out there. I think that's just folk. In the age of information, that is a dumb-ass thing to think. I think if you come to that place, you are a stupid motherfucker. If you think you can save Babylon, make that a better place. Cool, this is cool shit. This phone's right here. I like this shit. What is this? Okay. Then I heard another voice come from heaven say, come out of her, my people.
Hold on.
So that you will not share her sins.
Homeboy reading?
So you will not receive any of her plagues.
This dude reading.
For her sins are piled up to heaven. And God has remembered her cries.
Okay. I'm done.
Richest zip code in America, the 7th richest place in the world. Talk to me, it's rough life out here. Just getting it in. Give me y'all a little peek.
He got that white lady hanging up in his home because it's not his home, Dodo Bird.
Come on, come on. I got you. Yeah, family. I'm gonna check y'all later on Facebook because I gotta get to work. We can sting out. Yeah, we out here. Just making this split out. I'm gonna talk to y'all in about 10 minutes on Fisher Island. Fisher Island, I'm gonna talk to y'all. It's out here. Gotta figure this thing out. Check y'all later. I gotta call my man. Call my man and make sure I can find him. Peace to y'all. But I'm gonna get up with y'all on Facebook very soon so we can build about the amazing thing that's about to take place. I just got a great deal. So I'm gonna talk to y'all.
Look at this. Look at this. Some reason won't call the embassy. Blocking people who ask illogical questions. The people who say they're going to get her a free ticket at Spirit never come back. And she say they're not helping her. I say she blocking them. Because she's trying to get cash. Anybody who say they call their people. See, that was 5 hours ago. They never come back. When people tag them and ask them, have they helped her? She'll come back and say no, or she'll erase the comment. I've been checking this shit out. If she has a cheap non-refundable ticket, this is usually the outcome. They say she missed her flight twice. She claims she overslept. If you didn't have insurance on your ticket, then you lose your money. They will not let you book another flight unless you pay. This is not illegal, and the embassy can't do anything. The embassy can possibly help her get home. They didn't help the white boy get who Chief put out, but they might help her. When I worked for an airline in the past, we always allow passengers to fly standby on the next available flight out. Sometimes passengers would be at the airport all day long, but eventually there would be open seats on a flight that we could get them on. We would even work with the airlines that we partner with to help the passenger. Are you at the airport now? No, she's been trying to stay at a hotel. The best way to get them to help you is to be at the airport. Get to the airport. They're going to put you on standby, but at least you would know they're going to put you on a flight. You need to go to the airport. Standby. They will let you get on eventually. Lies. Go to the airport in person and they'll tell you to wait until there's a flight they can put you on. I thought you weren't leaving to Tuesday. Tuesday. So you missed two flights? She did. Y'all say call the embassy for every little thing. My God. All she has to do is go to the airport and wait on standby. Shaking my head. Y'all are insane. Now we know who calls 911 when the littlest thing does not happen in your favor. You need to actually stay at the airport. Just go to the airport and don't let up. You will eventually get put on a flight. Be nice, but act distraught. Don't have an attitude. That's what my ticket would look like right now if I went through the process and didn't finish. Where's the receipt showing that it was paid and booked? Check your DM. A copy of your ticket shows proof of purchase or record located. Otherwise, anyone could pretend to purchase a ticket and screenshot that screen. Don't get offended. There are too many scammers out here, and I don't want to be deceived. Go to the airport, sis. Girl, get that airport ticket. Oh, get to the airport and speak with the manager and supervisor if needed. DM me your ticket and I will help. There's a lot of people giving this girl money. Crazy. Go live and we know it's you and not a scammer. Or post a vid so we know you are okay. Just checking in. So has nothing been resolved? And yes, Spirit will put you on another flight for $100. I called and checked. But like I said, I'm just checking in on you. Are you okay? No, they won't. Today's flight is all booked. Yeah, that's why I looked it up for you. It was for tomorrow. So best suggestion is to go to the airport and explain to them. But I think people are skeptical about helping due to scammers and that your lives are in the dark. So they don't know what to believe. But yes, please go to the airport. Explain to them you miss your flight. And for those who say, yeah, they will send, at least they will see, hey, she is not scamming. I'll check on you later. That's usually what happens when you miss a flight. Normal protocol is to make you pay for a brand new ticket. It has happened to me before. It was my fault that I missed a flight. You guys, stop doing this young lady like this. It's not her problem. You all fell for the okey-doke from previous scammers. That's your fault. She's been through some serious humiliation and embarrassment. If she wants to wait to get herself together before she shows her face, that is more than understandable. We're going to ignore the part that she's already been on camera with the same haircut, but whatever. If you are going to help her, help her. If not, stop with the abuse because you really don't know if she's real or not. But if she's telling the truth, you doing nothing but adding more insult to injury. In my opinion, whether she's lying or not, she deserves to get donations way more than manipulating opportunity serenity. Off GP, Umi deserves way more respect than due. Now she continues to have issue after issue with getting home. Then when your eyebrows should go up, but for now, none of you really know Nature Boy got all of your donations of scammers paranoid as hell. Would you like me to contact Chief to see if he can help? Why are you making it so hard just to show where it says the ticket has been paid for? This is what mine looks like when entering my information before I hit buy. I'm willing to help. But what's their face burnt up so many times? You can't inbox me and I can send you something and get you back to the U.S. She says, I did. I've seen so many people tell her that.
So I missed my flight earlier. I was trying to see if anything could be done so that I could board a later flight. I'm stranded. I don't have any other way to get out of the country.
However, the flight that you would have missed would have already been deemed as a no-show. So in this case, you have to go to the airport to see if they can either put you on a standby or try to get you on another flight.
Girl. Saying you must have some kind of Wi-Fi if you're on social media. Two, you say your flight was Tuesday. How did I switch to Thursday? Three, you knew you didn't have money and that's why you needed donations for the care. What's really going on, sis? And you blocking people for asking logical questions. I mean, I think people want to help, but they have to see valid proof. Take a photo of your ticket and leave the hotel. Go live from the airport to... I'm sorry, but you're going to have to do some clear, concise communication with this particular situation as the people who have money to help are not going to budge until there is clear proof. We've been around for many years and have seen too many combination plots. So sorry, you're stuck, but you have to be completely 100, no shame. That's fair enough. I'll go live when I get to the airport. You're going to have to be 100% transparent right now. I don't mean any harm. I'm not trying to be negative, but there's no way in hell I would have missed my flight. I would have stayed up all night long. I think you will get donations, but not before you go live to prove that you are really stuck. I would go live at 12:30 Eastern from the airport. That did not happen. Y'all want her blood sample too? Either you gonna help or not. Stop with all this prove it to me shit. If you, what? Girl. Well, you give it all to it then. If you need people DNA sample to help them, then don't fucking help. Y'all act like she forcing y'all to donate your fucking money. I'm going to inbox you, hon, to see how I can help. Stop responding to these clowns in the comments. Ooh. Okay. Well, hey, give it all up. Give it all you got. Give it all you got. Give it all you got. Was her ticket date for Tuesday? Was there proof of that in the comments? Because I sure did read all the comments before I spoke. So maybe I missed that one. No, don't worry about it. You take care of all that. Y'all stop commenting. No girl got her. Don't even worry about it. Don't even worry about it, honey. She's about to check her other posts. No, she showed what she tried to act like she was booking a flight. That ain't no real receipt. And she blocked me because people were saying that it's Eligio put her in that situation. I said, how is it his fault she missed the flight? She blocked me ASA to the motherfucking P, okay? She sure did. I will go in on this chick, but I don't care that much. I ain't gonna blow a spot up like that. I'm not gonna blow it up all the way, okay? All the way. It says I missed my flight. It was for 2 a.m. and I slept straight through my alarm. Child, you were so tired, weren't you? If anyone can assist me, it would be greatly appreciated because for now, I'm stranded. No money, no working phone. I don't know what the hell she typing on, texting on, posting on, going live on. You know, in a foreign country where I don't speak the language. Oh. Here's my Cash App. Here's my PayPal. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying, man. Give it up. Give it up. Give it up. Said, please help if you can. I just want this whole ordeal to be over. Pull over. It's over. Pull over. At a hotel near Panama City Airport. Child, she at the hotel, okay? How much do you need? The flight is $500. The hotel is $40. For the flight, hotel, and food. Did she get what she needed? I hope so. Is it weird? Well, they meant to say, isn't it weird? But isn't it weird that she needs $500 when Nature Boy was asking people to donate $500? Oh, gosh, smack me in my face. I will buy the ticket and PayPal her. But she has to post a whole screenshot, not just half of it. Damn. Let me make a screenshot real quick. Hold on. I need to get me another gig because this ain't working. You see what I'm saying? The money ain't in what I'm doing. The money is in what they doing, okay? She said, I'll send it to you. DM me. And now how many people done said this, okay? This girl getting racks on racks on racks. Racks on racks on racks. No working phone? How? That's what I'm saying. You forgot the sway part, though. Type it right next time. You gotta say, how sway? Okay? No phone works on Wi-Fi only. Damn, y'all like the FBI. Help her or shut the fuck up. If you think it's for fag boy, just don't help her. Damn. The airlines will rebook your flight. You just have to be patient and patiently wait for the next flight out of there. Peace on your journey. They won't. They said I have to book a whole new flight. A whole new flight. Which airline is it? How much did you argue with them? Ask about the flat tire rule. It's usually up to discretion of the agent's facts. You need to speak to. They don't need to know you slept through it. You don't want people thinking this is some scam, so at least show you've already paid and has a ticket for those who might doubt you because of your Nature Boy affiliations and the fact that you went over there to scam Nature Boy and you slept with that nigga within a week with no condom. And then as soon as you left, you call yourself outing him and exposing him. And you thought that that was going to blow you up and you was going to be bigger than Nicki Minaj, but you didn't tell anything that nobody else already knew. You see what I'm saying? Okay. Mm-hmm. You already told him you overslept. Girl, you called somebody on the phone who answered a 1-800 number. You ain't even give them your name. They don't know who you are. Once you carry your butt down there and talk to people in their face, that's a whole nother situation. It's like starting all over again. Okay? You understand? Oh, boy. Child, stop playing with it. 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 But we'll see what happens. We'll see what happens with this story. Yeah, we'll see what happens. People that work for Spirit was telling her they're going to give her free flight tickets. She keeps saying no. They didn't help her. You know, people say inbox me to prove. You know. Da 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 da. Oh, here's one. Why didn't you go immediately to the airport after waking up realizing you missed your flight? They most likely would have helped instead of calling them via phone. I would have slept at the airport until someone helped me. Yeah. Mm-hmm. You see? But that's not what she did. She's still at the hotel telling people to pay for her hotel room and talking about she posted a video of her calling and saying, "Hi, I missed my flight." Girl, no. We seen in movies, okay? In movies, people get straight to the airport and beg and plead and look as pitiful as they can until they get some kind of deal worked out, okay? People that flew, has never flown before, know better than what you're doing right now, okay? All right? Okay? Look at all these people donating. All these people to Snapchat. Carmilla Latonya Jones will pay. Contact Carmilla. She will pay for you to come home. She helps all Carbonisha people come home. Child, I'm done. I'm done.
My arm's killing me. Ugh. Ow. Another race, they're always going to be the dominant, whether white or black. So they're always going to be the dominant. It was terrible. It was downright terrible. These people had to pee in a cup. Had no sunlight, nothing. Culture. It is a blatant disrespect and dishonor. On God forsaken island and start a new nation. For that. Everything. Everything that we were, that was negative, that is not us, to be let go. And erased. We're never going to forget what happened to our ancestors. And we're going to learn from that. And we're going to build on that. And our culture is being wiped out. Our kid is going to be white. Okay? There you go. There it is. Our kid is going to be white. Okay. Well, y'all kid is going to be white. Shake my butt. Shake my butt. Shake my butt.
Damn. Oh, yeah, y'all. Etha Flair went in this morning. Hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. Hold on.
Etha Flair TV. I'm gonna give y'all a little quick update. What's going on, masculinity, femininity, gods and goddesses, team me, please. Came out in this morning because I get a text message in my inbox. A matter of fact, in my Instagram box today, this morning, when I get up, because I'm in the dealership right now fixing my car, and I'm going to give you a breakdown of this dude named World News. He's out there, like how you call it, trolling me. So I'm going to break down World News reality right now because he's barking up the wrong tree. So you know World News? Get ready, because I'm going to come take. We're going to really speak this out, because if you saying you got something on me, what you got on me? Now let's talk about it. You's a phony dude, B. You trailing me, right? You Kim trailing me? You cloud chasing? You got the wrong man. You cloud chasing at the end. Cloud chasing the wrong man right now. So I'm going to tell you like this, fall back. You ain't never going to get an interview from me for trolling me, for coming at me sideways. What you got on me that I don't got on myself? Now let's talk. You got videos on me that you want to expose? Let's expose it, because I do this for fun, and I do this for real. You doing it just to play games with others, but I got you right now, because see me, you're going to see the hot emperor me talk right now. And now people going to be like, yo, why you talking reckless, man? So that nigga World needs a flat kite without no string, man, and see how far he's going to get with that for trolling me all day and every day. Then you're going to hit me up at 9 o'clock in the morning trying to threaten me because I don't want to give you an interview. So now you're going to get the interview from me and my platform. World News, you a lame dude. You the epiphany of my lowest self. You the type of person that I let go a long time ago, but now you trailing me because you want to get clout. You want cloud chase, right? So let's cloud chase. What you got on this brother that I don't got on me? Let's go there, so people could put you on. Where you at, World News? Come out and speak, or hold your peace, because you ain't never gonna get nothing from me at the end of the day. That's one. You cloud chasing me for what reason? What videos you got? Throw them out there, because I really want to start this holy spiritual war. Because I don't stand for shorts. I stand up for what it is. I don't stand for what lame frequency people do day in and day out. And if you're not doing the right thing, you're doing the wrong thing. And for coming at me sideways, now we're gonna start this game that you want to play. Because I'm not here to smash or trash talk anybody's platform. I'm here to better platforms, and I'm here to better my own. And if you're not here to better your own platform, then what you here for? You got the wrong brother, bro. And if you want to buck up the wrong tree, now you buck the right tree up. Now you woke me up. Now I just want to stay low from all y'all trash. We're fast with y'all platforms at the end of the day. So if you really want it, let's start this game. Because I'm going to send my spiritual team to make sure that you get it. You heard? And I'm not talking about physical. I'm talking about spiritual energy, man. You ain't got no energy or any entity that could come up and bark up this road, because I got dignity. I know what's my purpose on this earth. Do you know your purpose? My purpose is to heal myself and heal others and continue this journey in the most righteous path and the most righteous way I can. And I see that you want to turn up, and you want to turn up for the wrong reason. So now let's turn up. And I'm not talking about physical violence and none of that. I'm talking about now let's deal with the thought. Your thought is very low frequency, brother. And you've been trying to get at me for the longest, trying to get an interview from me. And I tell you to fall back, because I don't want you to interview. That's one. Two, you're not going to get an interview from me. Three, whatever you got to say and expose, because it's going to ricochet right back on your platform like what you are. The lower self vibration of I don't know what. Man, raise up the bar, man. Get your pH balance up to 7.5 to 12 and stop talking the real shit. Because you're talking the opposite of what it is. And I ain't with that World News trash talk, man. You coming on everybody's platform talking another language. And you know where I'm at. I do not hide. I'm in Rhode Island, and I ain't got time to hide from social media or say what it ain't or start talking about somebody else in ways where it doesn't add up for me, someone else, and beyond. So if you really want it, man, stay in your lane, man, and come at me correctly, man. Cause I'm gonna put out there how you been coming at me in my inbox on some lame nigga shit. You a lame nigga, man. I'm gonna tell you straight up in your face. I tell you wherever I see you, lame, bro. And you cloud chasing the wrong tree, my nigga. That's all I can tell you. So if you ready, bring it, brother. Cause at the end of the day, I ain't trying to hear you or any lower self frequency vibration entities, bro. And if you are about yours, then stand up for the right things. Don't stand up for the wrong. Hashtag do what's right. And you don't want to do what's right. You want to keep trash talking, brother. And that's what I'm trying to tell you. Fall back from my platform. Because what I do here is enlighten people to do the right thing. To continue to do right bottoms, bodies for themselves so others can see they could do better. better yourself at all times, brother, because you're trying to come up on these platforms trolling people for no reason. And at 9 o'clock in the morning, you trolling the right one, because this is when you turn me up. This is when my higher self kick in. My higher emperor, nigga, I'm an emperor at the end of the day, man. My masculinity, femininity straight on lock. So it is what it is, man. I'm going to put you on blast, too, because at the end of the day, the documentation beats conversation. The truth is always going to stand. A lie is going to fold up. The devil's a liar. He come to kill, steal, and destroy through other people's platform when they trying to figure out something they don't even understand themselves. Put yourself on a high vibration and understand the divine being that you could be and tap into yourself. Stop trying to tap into everybody else. And be careful what you're tapping into, because you be tapping into the wrong things and then coming at the people for the wrong things. Come at me for the right things. Talk to me about building and making something better, building a platform, even uniting. But you don't want to do that. You want to talk trash all day, man. You like carbonation, nigga. You like Nature Boy, man. You like Brother Polite, nigga. That's what y'all niggas do, man. Y'all niggas come steal, and kill, steal, and destroy everything that's not yours. And ask your boy, Brother Polite, and ask your boy, Nature Boy, who they dealing with, man. I go to your platform to better it, and if it's not going to get better, I'll bounce on y'all niggas, man. Y'all niggas is some fucking low self-vibration, some slave. Y'all still in that slave mentality, man. You free to go, man. Take your freedom, man. And stop trying to buck up the wrong trees and try to take niggas down with you, because you ain't going nowhere fast, brother. Straight up, man. This ain't just to talk, man. I'm just going to put you where it is, put you on front. You want to be on front line? Nah, let's get it. Holla at me. Keep coming at me sideways in my inbox. And I'm going to put all the messages out there, how you coming at me, talking to me sideways like I'm a bow down to another lame nigga. You crazy? I would never bow down to no other man. Especially if you're talking the opposite of what it is that don't benefit you, someone else, or anybody watching your platforms or mines. Turn up. Because you talk a lot of trash, man. And if you out there watching, because you change your world news carbon, you change your platform so many times. Keep it on that same platform, on that same frequency. Stop changing pages and making 20,000 accounts. I only got one account, brother. Straight up, man. And you ain't, and whatever videos you got of me, let's get it. Spit them videos out, boy. Because this is when I stand up for the truth. I know what my purpose on life, man. I give life and I don't take life, man. I don't walk through the valley of death, nigga. I walk through the valley of life, and I protect and serve it at all times. And you mad at that? Because my eyes open already. I see my low vibrations. I can see what it is. I don't see what it ain't no more. I see what it is. Good or bad, bad and good. And I know what to do is fight at the end of the day for this. Understand what I'm saying? This is why I cleaned the house. This is why I lost so many people on this journey, on this narrow path, because it's not for so many people. You know what I mean? You have to lose a lot of people so you can actually see where you stand with yourself and others, doing the right thing for yourself and others. And when you do that, yo, you start losing a lot of fake people. Yo, the love is so fake and the hate is so real, man. This is what I try to tell y'all, man. Y'all gotta be careful who y'all talk to day in and day out. Who you think is on your side when they really not on your side. They just cloud chasing. I call them treasure trolls, man. Yo, turn yourself into a troll. Don't come back out your womb, man. And stay in there, man. Stay there permanent, man, because you don't even know what you're doing, man. You want to broadcast and you want to be a what? A reporter. A reporter what? A trash talk, man? Talk like a girl, man. Get on your masculine shit and do what's right already, man. And stop trash talking everybody else and talk positivity into the universe. Because I ain't talking trash. Fall back for me because you got the right one again. It's your boy Eat the Flair, man. Marcel Pagan, man. Straight up, you want my address? I expose addresses and everything because you're not going to do nothing. Spiritually, my angels protect me day in and day out. How you like that, man? And you don't want them niggas to come after you. Straight up, because I set your whole platform just by just talking positive energy into the universe and make sure my angels take care of that for me. Because you light work, bro. Remember that, you're light work. And light workers like you, my nigga, ain't going nowhere, man. Put that cause and effect of something positive, and at the end of the day, make sure you do what's right. Because if you're doing what the opposite of what it is that's right, boy, make sure you're going to see that shit is going to haunt you. That's going to be the biggest mistake you ever do on your platform. Talking trash just to talk trash and speak shit that you don't even add up to, man. You don't even know the brother here. You ain't even give yourself the opportunity to get to know me one-on-one, even on the phone, because you too quick to get the upload to the download of the lowest self-frequency vibration, world news. Take that shit to the bank. And whoever vibes with you, tell them I said that. Tell them I said world news is trash, nigga. Straight up, man. And I'm not talking about physically. I'm talking about spiritually. I'ma turn your ass upside down, brother. Straight up. You don't even want to get there, bro. Mentally, you don't even want to take it there, man. I'ma let the energy of good spirits and the good vibrations of what it is take care of your ass for me, brother. So prepare yourself, man. That full moon is coming, boy, the 23rd, man. Stop playing with me, man. At the end of the day, man, because I do what's right day in and day out for myself and others. And those who know me day in and out, they know what I'm talking about. I'm talking about nutrition. I'm talking about bettering people's well-being, health, putting people's pH balances to 7.5 to 12. Anything else after that, I don't want to hear it. Don't hit me in my inbox. Don't come at me solid with negative energy, because if you're not coming with positive energy in my inbox, stop hitting me up, brother. Straight up, man. I'm telling you the most righteous way I could tell you. Stop hitting me up in my inbox talking trash, because that's what you're talking day in and day out, bro. Straight up, I got nothing to talk to you about, man. I represent motherfucking Dr. Sebi all day, nigga. That's all I'm about is Dr. Sebi. I'm about Dr. Sebi's nutrition. I'm about Dr. Sebi's movement, and I'm about my movement. Straight up. I'm opening up a restaurant. You're not about opening up a restaurant and doing something for someone else and you and beyond. Don't fuck with me, brother. Straight up, man. You got me talking because now I'm tired of y'all niggas sizing me up day in and out in these fucking social media platforms behind the scenes in these inboxes. Like y'all about this, man. Stop, man. Join the team, man. Team me. Join the team and do what's right. Hashtag do what's right, man. And be a team player. Stop being a team hater, man. Straight up, man. You hating on me, you hating on yourself. And if you ain't got nothing nice to say, don't say nothing to me, brother. At all. Yeah. That's what he needs. He needs balance in his life, man. I'm up there 777 all day, man. I manifest everything in the physical room and for the righteous ways, for the righteous things. And those who rock with me is gonna rock. And those who ain't gonna rock me ain't gonna rock. Cause some people like my energy and some people don't. I can't get everybody to be on my page or be on their own page talking the same frequency, cause we a family thing. This is a family thing. This is a spiritual family thing. And on social media. And those people know, boy, these demons is fucking liars, man. Them low vibrations people, man. Stop eating good, man. Get on Dr. Sebi's nutritionist, man. Get that exclusive package from Dr. Sebi and detox yourself, man. Cause you need help, brother. Straight up. So bring that pain, man. I do this cause I love doing this. This is what I have in me. This is in my heart, brother. I don't have to get paid to put you on blast and stand for who I am in the divine masculinity that I am and femininity balanced out in this universe, brother. So if that's what you want, bring the pain, bro, because you're the only one who's going to feel that pain, mentally, physically, and emotionally. Not physically, but mentally, man. And you don't want to take it there mentally. You see, I'd rather a nigga fuck me up at the end of the day. That pain will go away, the black and blues. But mentally and emotionally, take that shit off my platform, brother. Talk to me correctly, because I talk day in and day out correctly to others, to myself, my significant others, brothers, sisters, everybody on this platform. I come correctly. So keep doing what's right, family. Keep doing what the universe has taught you, and do what's right. Because everybody knows what to do once again, and do whatever they want. Especially when they see another brother who's an enlightened, melanated brother, they start talking the frequency of a dark melanated brother. Because niggas be like, oh, why you trying to act black? I don't know what you talking about, man. I know about melanin, and my melanin is high, and I respect myself like I respect others. Because you need two people in a relationship to respect. Because you can say you respect yourself, but do you respect someone else? You can say you love yourself, but do you love someone else? And continue to love yourself, because we're here to show love. It's the universal language, and it's the one fucking piece missing. So we can all get it at the end of the day, nigga. That one piece that's missing in that puzzle. Everybody would get this message. My phone is dying now. It's had like 37%. And I'ma continue this message for world news, man. Kick rocks, man, with an open toe sandal. See how far you go with that, man. And stay off my platform, man. And stop inboxing me. Whatever you have on me, put it out there and expose it. Because I'm ready. This is what I was made for, man. I chose this moment in life, for my past life, to stand here for myself and others, to do what's right at all times. Straight up. I ain't with the domestic violence. I ain't with none of that. Niggas who bring that shit around me, who want to physically harm people, come on, bring that wrath, man. I'm like the tsunami for niggas like you, man. I show you, man, I protect, serve everything in life. And niggas from day one, my hood niggas already know how I move, man. And we ain't bringing the peace, man. We ain't bringing nothing. And it's always going to be peace in my world, peace and love. And that's why people don't like me. From day one, they know I'm the solution to your fucking problems. And if you don't like it, then Don't come on my platform, don't watch me, don't promote me, don't support me, but do what's right for yourself first. For others to see through you, they could do the same. But since you want to see the higher emperor, me, you want to see my low vibration. No, I'm in my high self neutral right now. That's what I'm doing. I'm on my high self neutral state in my statement right now. So whatever you got, bring it, man, like a bull that I am, and bring it into my stable. Because I tell you, keep yourself 5 feet away from me. A bull is nice and calm and collective. I admire everything this life. I admire art. I admire music. I admire talent, especially positive talent, brother. Your talent, I don't know what the fuck your talent is about. And I don't know what your reporting is about. And I don't know how you try to assassinate people through you. But you ain't assassinating this entity. I'm energy, bro. I will never die. I will manifest something bigger and greater and transform into that. Before you even think you're going to introduce me to your lower self. Man, introduce your lower self to your higher self and leave them on the neutral state. World news. That's what you need to do, brother. And stay away from me, bro, because I'm turning up on you now. Straight up. You try to get at Nature, boy. You couldn't get at him. You try to get on everybody else's problem. You got on my platform on Time Live when I was on live talking that trash talk like you wanted something positive on me. But when I didn't give you the interview because I got my own platform to interview myself, brother, and those that I want to interview you will interview me in my platform. Like I told you, I wanted to run up on you in your town, and you ain't even want that, brother. What happened to you? You scared of my energy? Y'all ain't even gonna tell them my location. I pull up on you. What's good? Pull up on me. I'll give you the interview. If you got the heart, pull up on me. I'll sit you in my living room, bro, and feed you a meal that you ain't never ate in your life, nigga, and show you how I show love to them haters so they can vibrate to my state of frame of mind at the end of the day, man. Because I love myself and love others more, man. And see me stay strong, man, because the devil's a lie. Come kill, steal, and destroy everything that's not his. Especially when you're talking like this for yourself and others. Nigga, everybody's like, yo, yeah, that's a bird-ass nigga. Straight up, even that nigga mentality of slavery, man. Ain't no more slavery, man. That was all in the mental, man. Straight up, everybody was not slaves at one point, man. Those who chose to be slaves, man. I ain't no slave here. Take your freedom, man. Stop earning a life, man, and live life. That's what it is. Take your freedom already. Ain't nobody owe you nothing. I don't owe you nothing. It look like I owe you something, brother. Straight up. And whatever I owe you, I pay it in full in the physical room, brother. Come see it. What you want? Withdraw it? What you want to withdraw? Something that ain't yours? So stay in your lane, man. Whatever I gotta say, I'ma say to my platform. I'ma respect my platform. But those like you, man, I tell y'all ones, new ones, with the thought, man. If I can't beat you with the thought, I can't beat you physical. So I'm not trying to beat you physical no more. I'ma show you what it really is from this point forward, brother. Come on my page and I'ma put your little fucking phony ass texts that you put in my inbox so the world can see what type of person you are when you're trying to get at people for interviews and how you approach them. And your lower self talking to me sideways. I never answered to none of your texts like we was going somewhere. And when I gave you the opportunity, you be me because you ain't want me to go to your town. Brother, don't lie, man. I said, yeah, where you at? I'ma pull up on you so you can interview me live on your house and your block, wherever you have your little palace going on, your little honeycomb hideout, man, because you hiding. I ain't hiding, man. I do interviews live. Anywhere anybody want to see me, I'll pull up. Whoop. Where we at? What we talking about? What you want to know about me? What you want to question me about? Been doing this. Been in a relationship for 24 years. Been with my family since day one, since 17 years old. Been by myself for 2 years. What nigga? What everybody want to know about me? Want to know about my mother. Want to know about my father. Want to know about my brothers and sisters. Everybody's on a different platform. Everybody's on a different vibration. You know what I mean? And when I speak like this, you know, you lose people, even your family members. They be like, oh, he's talking some other. Yes, I'm talking high vibrational shit. Oh, I'm talking about third eye shit. I'm talking about healing. Everybody's looking for healing, even from being heartbroken from a significant other or a friend or a child. You know how many times you've been heartbroken and people say they're not looking for healing? They out of their mind. Because everything is, you have a thought to break out from the low self thoughts with the solution. And have the solution day in and day out. Straight up. If you don't want to be the solution, you want to be the problem, man. Stop healing y'all. Heal yourselves, man. Straight up. And people who already know what I'm talking about, they're already there. This is a universal thing. Families get it. Families' frequency, love is understanding. Families' business, love is law.
And I'm going to keep saying that, man. And I'm going to keep loving myself. And I'm going to keep loving what I'm doing because I do this for fun. I don't even get paid for doing this. Even to bring out information that people don't even know about. Nobody know about Dr. Sebi. Dr. Sebi came and went. And Nipsey Hussle had to die. Lisa Left Eye Lopez had to die for him to get the recognition. Then him too? Come on, man. Not us. As the people. To keep ourselves healthy day in and day out. Have to follow what's right. If not, we are following the opposite of what it is. We ain't fucking with Babylon. I ain't fucking with Babylon. I ain't fucking with anything that comes to kill, steal, and destroy the earth that is cancer. Yeah? It's a bunch of cancer people out here. Once you turn into that cancer, now everybody around you start feeling it, man. Please, man. Straight up, don't bring that shit over here, man. No more, man. Because I got something for you at all times, man. And I'm going to stay on my page at all times doing what I got to do. You might not see me for a couple of days because I'm out here on my journey, adding it up, putting it together mathematically to get something going on for myself and others, even if I got to do it myself because I don't want nothing in return that I can't give myself. Brother, always remember that. And anybody that knows me know I come strong, straight up. 100,000, 200,000, whatever it is, I come strong. Just to make sure that we do the things that's right, not the things that's wrong. And if that's what y'all talking about, doing the wrong things, by getting on people's page, trolling people for the wrong thing, and trying to size people up for wrong interviews, Jesus, bro. My highest self is going to really stand his ground from now on this point. Because I'm, yes, at the end of the day, we all chiefs. We chief, I'm a chief of command of my earth ship at all times. And those who fuck with me day in and day out know me. I seek you, I see you. You know, brother, stay positive. You heard? House of Ezekiel. Ezekiel. Or Ezekiel. That's my boy right there, showing love at all times. And love right back too, you heard? I met him out here in RIP. And that man is talking a high frequency. I'm going to do a team of Tauruses because I see them Taurus people really get it. They grounded, earthbounded. You know what I mean? We are here. I'm the yin of the earth. And you got to come to me to see me. I don't got to go to see you. We are here. We on planet Earth, man, the human race, man, the melanated people, bro, from the lighter version of me to the darker version of me. All that white and black shit is over, man. Straight up, man, I don't comprehend that, especially when you're trying to divide and conquer me for the wrong reason and keep me away from saying the truth and standing up for the truth and speaking for myself and others, because when I speak loud. Straight up, people don't like that. Oh, you talk to me. You get it, though, right? As long as you get it, that's all that matters. I'm very passionate. Yes, I'm very passionate. You know what I mean? And I take it seriously. And a lot of people don't take this seriously. This is why I walk by myself day in